I'm Violet Oon, and we're in Singapore today. And I'll be doing two dishes. The first one is a sort of part of our Cantonese culture, which is chicken in a clay pot. And I'll be cooking in this clay pot, which is quite sort of interesting. You cook and serve in it. You don't have to have a clay pot. You could have a casserole dish that can be put on top of an open fire. First, you heat up about 2 cups of oil till it's very hot, till a haze appears. Well, my oil is about right. One way is sort of you put a chopstick in for us, and if there sort of sizzles, the oil sizzles around it, it's sort of hot enough. Now I'm putting in the shallots first because they take longer to fry. I'm going to deep fry it, and then you get it to a nice golden color. Then the next ingredient I'm going to have in is the garlic. And you get it into a nice sizzle. And the third one would be the ginger. The ginger, all these of course have to be peeled first before you cook it. But you could eat the garlic and the shallots. It's lovely to have them deep fried and then stewed in this dish. You have a sieve ready. You can see it's all a nice golden color. And then I just drain it here. And I'm going to remove the wok. And then I'll turn on the heat. And then I'm going to use what is known as cooked oil. Oil that has been used to fry something else. And this one is perfect cooked oil because I've fried the onions, garlic and shallots in it. I'm going to use about 1 tablespoon. I've heated up the clay pot. It takes a long time to heat up. And then I'm going to be frying these ingredients again. I'm putting this in and letting it sort of fry well. It has to get hot. When you're cooking in a clay pot, it's useful to have a pair of chopsticks. And then I would have my chicken and about 1 pound clean. And you know, you just stir it with a pair of chopsticks. You find it's very convenient rather than a ladle. I'm going to stir it for about 2 minutes and get it nicely browned a little. And I'm adding now, I have about half a cup of chicken stock. And then I'm going to add all these sauces. Light soya sauce, dark soya sauce, the wine, and the oyster sauce. Now I'm going to leave it. It has come to a beautiful boil, and turn it down low and let it sort of simmer for about 20 minutes to half an hour. This is not a stew that should be very, very soft. It's a Cantonese version which the meat is still firm and juicy. And then perhaps the pepper. Here I have Chinese mustard greens. Traditionally, you should actually pluck vegetables rather than cut them if you're sort of very old-fashioned. All you do at the end of it is to put these vegetables on top, and you steam the vegetables actually on top of the chicken, and you don't fry it. Okay, I'm quite ready for my vegetables. You see it's sort of sizzling nicely. I'll just put a bit of vegetables on top, just enough not to sort of overwhelm it, so I can put the cover back on again. And I'm just going to leave it to steam for about 2 or 3 minutes till the vegetables are limp and change color. You don't want it too soft, sort of for Chinese cooking and Cantonese cooking. You find that Cantonese food is sort of very pure and everything is sort of a la minute and cooked just right. You see my vegetables are turning a nice sort of beautiful green, and they are nearly done. At this stage, I would turn off the heat and leave it covered, because what happens is that the clay pot, being an earthenware, continues to keep the heat, and you find that the sauce keeps on bubbling although the heat is off. And that's why I say it's a lovely winter dish, because for us from the kitchen and it's served on the table, you find that the sauce is still bubbling for about 2 or 3 minutes on the table, and when you're eating, and it keeps the dish hot throughout the meal. Now the dish is ready. I just lift off the cover, put it on a plate, And then there you have this, and ready to be served with steamed rice and with a pair of chopsticks.